Good morning, children. Welcome back to maths class. Myself, Shalini. So, children, which topic we were discussing in our last class? Remember? Yes. We were discussing a topic that is playing with numbers. So, which topic, children? Yes, it was playing with numbers. Yes, no, children? In that, what all we have discussed, remember? I hope you all remembered, okay? So in today's class, we are going to discuss about prime factorization. So what we are going to discuss, children? Yes, we are going to discuss the prime factorization. So before going to that, I hope you all know the prime numbers. Yes, no? Can you tell which are the prime numbers? Okay, 2, 3, then 5, 7. These all are what? Yes, they are prime numbers. So I hope you all remember, children, about prime number, composite numbers I have explained in my class. Okay? So like 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, these all are the prime numbers. Likewise 4, then like 6, 8, these all we call them as a composite number. Okay? Now, today we are going to discuss about the prime factorization. So let us see the definition. Okay. Prime factorization is when a number is expressed as a product of prime factors. So they give you one number, you need to factorize it. How to factorize it, children? Yes, you have to factorize in such a way that their product should be a prime numbers. So what, children? What is prime factorization? Any number you can take, you have to factorize that number in such a way that their product must be in the, means their product must be prime numbers. So here I have written you one example, and usually prime factorization we can do by factor tree method, which you all have learned in your previous class, I think. In 5th standard, you all have learned about factor tree. That is in factors and multiples lesson. You have how to make the factors tree and all. You all have learned. Okay. So now you can use a factor tree to find the prime factorization of a number. So all you can see here, well, is one number. Yes, no, children? Okay. So now you have to factorize it. How we are going to factorize? Yes, you all know. 12 is going to come in 2's table. It is going to come in 3's table. Yes, no, children? Again, it's going to come in 4's table. Okay. But here we want to make them as a prime factorization. So I have taken 2's is a 12. I hope you all know 2's is a, it is going to come 12. Okay. Then already you all know 2 is a prime. Leave it. Again, further you factorize this 6. How we are going to factorize, children? Yes. 2, 3 is a 6. Okay. Again, all you can see here. 2 and this 3 are the prime numbers. So in this way, you need to factorize a number. So let me give one more example. Okay, you can take any number. You can take 18. So please try to factorize it, children, by factor 3 method. So you can take 3 6. Yes, no? 3 7 is going to come. Or else you can take 2 9. Whichever you feel easy, you can take. So 3 6 18. Already 3 is a prime. Okay, now further divide the 6 like 2 and 3. So in this way you can do, or else this 18 you can do like 2 9s are. Yes or no? 2 9s are 18. Then further you can divide it as 3 3s are 9. So there are so many ways to do the factorization, whichever you feel you have to do. Which you can do either 3 6 1 method, or you can use 2 9 are, yeah, okay. But you have to get the answers in prime, then only we say it as a prime factorization. So children, all you can see here, 3. So the prime factors of 18 are 3 into 2 into 3. So now when you multiply 3 2s are 6, 6 3s are 18. So all you can see the factors of 18. Factors of 18 are what? 3, 2, 3. That is, all these are prime number. Now, another method it is going to differ. So here all you can see 2, 3, 3. So they all are prime number. So this is all about the prime factorization. It's very simple, children. They give you a number. You need to find by 3 methods. So in page number 62, page number 62, question number 2, page number 62, exercise 3.5, children, page number 62, exercise is 3.5, and question number 2, they have given you the 3, incomplete 3 they have given, you need to complete using the prime factorization, okay? So, page number 62, they have given incomplete 3, you need to complete that. So, what is that, children? Okay, all you have to open your books, you need to copy whatever I am giving, okay? You need to write this definition, you have to write the lesson name. I hope you all are doing, okay? So, page number 62, question number 2. So, they have given a 3, incomplete 3, you need to complete it. So this is the 3 given, children, that is incomplete 3, you need to complete it. Any idea, children, how you are going to complete? Okay, I'll tell you how to complete it. So you all know 60. So when you multiply 16 to 10, you are going to get 60. Okay, then now you 6 is there, we need to factorize it. So already one number they have given as 2. So what I should do with 2 to get 6? So what I should multiply? What I should multiply 2 to get 6? I know you all know the tables. Yes, you know 2's table? Yeah, very good. So 2 3's are 6. So when you multiply 2 3's are, you are going to get this 6. So 1 box, it is going to come 3. Now likewise, here it is 5. Already they have given you one number. Or here it is 10. Sorry, here it is 10. But already they have given you one number as 5. So what I should do, or what I should multiply with this 5 to get 10, children? Yes, you all know 5's table. It's 5, 2's are 10. Very simple, yes, no? Then you all can see 2, 3, 5, 2. All are prime number. 2 is a prime, 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number. Okay. So, 1 more, 3 they have given. 1 more, 3. So, in this method is different. So, in this it is different. Just note it down, children. We are going to, okay. So, now we all know it is 30. So, it is 30 and here it is 60. What I should do with this 30 to get 60, children? So, 30 is stable. 13 twos are, you are going to get 60. So, in this circle, you need to write 2. Okay. Then here it is 30 and here they have given us 10. Okay. What I should multiply with 10 to get 30? Yes, it is 3. So, 10 threes are, you are going to get 30. Next, come to 10. What I should do? Both are empty? Yes. You can write it as 2 5s are 10. Okay. Now all you can see 2, 5, 3, 2. These all are prime numbers. Okay. I hope you all understood. Okay. Again in that third question, children. You can see third question. Which factors are? Please open your video book, page number 62. You have an exercise 3.5. I'm going to solve some of the important problems, not all. Okay? Which all are important, and you will explain them. So in that, again, third question is for children. Which factors are not included in prime factorization of a number? So I hope you all remember, I have told one number which is neither prime number nor composite number. Which is that number, children? Yes, it is 1. So, what is the third question? Which factors are not included? are not included in the prime factorization. Prime factorization offers prime factorization over composite number. So, which is that number, children? Yes, in my last previous class, I have explained that one is neither prime nor composite. So, same you have to write. So, one is the factor. One is the factor which is not included in the prime factorization. One is the factor. So, what is the answer, children? Yes, one is the factor which we are not going to include in the prime factorization of a composite number. So, what is the third answer? So, one is the factor which we are not going to include in the prime factorization of a composite number. Okay, in that, fourth, shall we move to the fourth question? Okay, what is the fourth question, children? Please read it out. Read it out. Yes. Write the greatest four-digit number. I hope you all know the greatest four-digit number. What is that? Yes, it is 9999. So, what is the fourth question, children? Shall I write? Write the greatest. Write the greatest. Write the greatest four digit number and express it in terms of its prime factor. And express it in terms of prime factors. So, what is, I hope you all know, which is the greatest four digit number, children? It is 9999. Yes, no? So, before going to write, you can write the greatest four digit number. First, you write the number. Then, you have to make the factor tree of that and you have to find the prime factors. So, the greatest four digit number is 9999. That you find the factor tree of it. Okay. So I hope you all know. You all have understood. So 3333 into 3. If you make, you are going to get 9999. Already 3 we have got. Next, you factorize this 3333. How? Again you make 3 here. Okay. Again 1, 1, 1. It's very simple. So 3 into 1 and 1 means what we need this number? 1111. So when you multiply 3 into with this number, you are going to get 3333. Okay. Now this, again further you divide this number. 101 into 11. Further, how to divide this number? Here we will get 11, and here it is 1, and here it is 3. So, what are the prime factorization of this, children? 9999. You have to divide in such a way that you all know 3 into 3333. If you make, you are going to get 9999. Again, further divide this 3333 as 3 into 1111. Okay. Then further divide this 1111 as 101 into 11. Please, you can check it. You can multiply and you can see you are going to get the same answer. So, this is how we can factorize the greatest four digit number. Okay. Shall shall we move to the next question? Okay. Next question is about smallest 5-digit number. So, what is the next question, children? You have to factorize the smallest 5-digit number. Shall we do it? Okay. Write the question.
Write the smallest 4-digit number.
Next, 5th question, children. Write the smallest. Write the smallest 5-digit number and express, and that you have to express in terms of its prime factor, and express it in terms of prime factors. Okay, so I hope you all know the smallest 5-digit number.
Yes, it is
10,000. So first you write the smallest 5-digit. The smallest 5-digit number is what, children? Yes, it is 10,000. Okay. I hope you all know how to write it. Okay. Then you need to factorize this 10,000. So now factorize this number, children. Any idea? Yes, please do it. Okay, you can make 2 into 5,000. Yes, sir. Yes. Again, you divide this 5,000. 5,000 into 2. If you make here, you have to get 10,000. Okay. Next 5,000 you divide, children. 2 into 25,000. So when you make 2 into 25,000, you are going to get 5,000. Then you divide, children. 25 into 100. So 25 into 100, if you make, you are going to get 2,500. Okay. Then last. Let me write small so that space is spare. So it is 10,000. So 2 into 5,000. Then again you divide this, children. 2 into 2,500. Yes, sir. You are going to get. Then further. So 2 into. Again further you divide this, children. 25 into 100. Again this 25. 5 into 5. Again this 100 you divide. 10 into 10. Yes. Again that 100 you have to divide. 10 tens are 100. Again this 10. Just a point here. So this 10 again you can further divide it as 5 into 2. Again this 10 as 5 into 2. It is continuation part, children. Don't write once again. Here again you make the columns and you have to write it here. Here this is not enough. So I am writing. Or shall I write? Okay, wait. I am going to write this side. Please don't get confused. Okay. I am going to draw the factor tree of 10,000 considering this side. So 10,000. So 2 into 5,000. Okay. First step. Again, further you divide this 5,000 as 2 into 2,500. Okay, children. Again, this you divide it as 25 into 100. You are going to get 40. Next, this 25 you can divide it as 5 as 25. Then this 10 tens are. Then this 100 you can write it as 10 tens are. Okay. Then again this 10, 5 tens are. Again this 10 as 5 tens are. So this is the complete tree of 5-digit small number, means smallest 5-digit factor tree. Both are same. Yes, you may get confused. Let's try our method. Please see this smallest 5-digit this factor tree. Okay. Shall we move to the next question, children? Okay. What is the next question in that? Find all the prime factors of 1729
each name in ascending order. Okay.
Now, what is the next question? Please take the question from your book. Take the question. They have given you one number. You need to find the factors. So, this is the factor tree of the smallest five-digit number. Okay.
Then, what is the next question?
Sixth question. Find all the prime factors of 1729 and arrange them in ascending order. Please note down the full question table. Now state the relation, if any, between two consecutive prime numbers. Okay, first continue the question. Okay, then you have to find the prime factors of this number, children. Yes, so you have to divide this number. You are going to get the prime factors. So when you divide this number like this, division method you can use to get the prime factors. Okay. So now you can divide with 7. 7 is 14. I hope you all know this method, children. How I have got this 247, 13 and 19. I am going to show you. Okay. First you should divide this number by 7. So you have to see the last number. Either you can divide this number by 3 or 7. Why? Because in 3 table and in 7 table you are going to get the number 9. Okay. Now I am going to start with this big 7, and you all know 7 is 14, but here it is 17, so you can minus here 14. So 17 minus 14, you are going to get 3. Yes, no? 3 is going to left. So 7 is 14, here 3 is left, and we need this number as 32. Okay, now you know all 7 is table. 7 is 28. Means from this 32, from that 32, you have to do minus 28. So how much is left, children? Here it is left with 4. Okay. Now you have a 7. 7 is a. Yes, no? So 7, 7 is a 49. So we got the first factors as 7 and 247. Okay. Now you can divide. You can divide this number with 13. Okay, now you can divide this number with 13. So you all know 13 is table, 13 is the 13, 13 to the 26. What is that? It is 26, but we have the 24. So we cannot take 2's up. We have to take it as 1's up. So 13 is the 13. So minus here, 24 minus 13, 24 minus 13. If you make, you are going to get how much table? Here 1, 11 is left. So 24 minus 13, 24 minus 13, 11 is left. And you all know 13 is table. 13 nines are 117. So what is 13 nines? It is 117. So now we got the 247 as 13 and 19. So further, we cannot divide 13 and 19. As you all know, 7, 30, 19 are the prime factors. Okay. So in this way, you can get the factors by division method, or else you can use the factor tree method. Okay. Now one more statement I have given you, children, that you have to arrange them in ascending order. So 7, 2, 9 is 3, 30 and 19. So you all know what is ascending order. From smallest to greatest, you have to arrange the factors. So all you can see, 7, 30, 19. From smallest to greatest, we have arranged. Okay. Next, one more question we have given in that. Any relation, whether you are going to get or what? Yes, we are going to get the relation that the difference between two conjugative. So the difference between two conjugative The difference between two consecutive prime numbers is 6. So all you can see 13 minus 7 we are going to 6 and 19 minus 13 we are going to get 6. So the difference between these consecutive numbers is 6. So this is our grouping question 6. Okay.
Next, 7th question. The product of 3 consecutive numbers is always divisible by 6. Verify this statement with the help of some examples. So, please try this question, children. If it gets well and good, otherwise I will tell you in my next class. You need to try this because you all know the 6 table and you all know the consecutive numbers are nothing but the continuous number. You have to take some continuous number and what you have to make, children? You have to make the product of 3 consecutive numbers.
Like, consecutive numbers are nothing but like 1, 2, 3. Which you have to take 3 continuous numbers, any number, right? You can take 3, 4, 5. Means that should be continuous. Then you have to take the product. Product means 3 into 4 into 5. So you have to get the product of 3 consecutive numbers. Then you have to check whether that product is divisible. Whether this product is divisible by 6 or not. So, you have to try on your own. Okay.
Then, shall we move to the next question? 8th question. Yes. Again, it is same, children. In 7th question, they have given you the product. Whereas in 8th question, they have given the sum of 2 consecutive odd numbers is divisible by 4. Here, they have given the odd numbers.
So, I hope you all remember what are the odd numbers?
1, 3, 5, 7, 11, 9, so on are the odd numbers. Okay. Here, what you have to do, children? You have to take the sum of 2 consecutive odd numbers.
Like, you can take 2 consecutive odd numbers. In the sense, 3 minus 1 plus 3. Consecutive means 1 after 3 is going to come. You cannot take 1 plus 5. Because it is not going to become consecutive. Okay? So, you have to take 2 consecutive numbers like 1 plus 3, 4. And you all know this 4 is divisible by 4. Likewise, you can take another consecutive. 3 is one consecutive odd number. After 3, 5. Yes, no? Now you can take 5 plus 3, 8. Yes. Again, it is divisible by 4. In this way, you have to take the consecutive odd numbers. So next consecutive odd numbers you can take 5. After 5, which is the odd number, children?
9?
No, it is 7. Then 5 plus 7, 12. So again this 12 is divisible by 4.
So such pairs you have to
make and you have to find whether this sum are divisible by 4 or not.
Please these two questions try. Okay. Then 9th question is what, children? In which of the following expression prime factorization has been done?
So, 4 questions they have given. You have to tell among that which are prime factors. Okay? Shall we? Okay. First, I write the question. Please, I think you have to write on your own. 9th question. In that, 4 statement they have given. 24 is written as 2 into 3 into 4. Then B. 56, 7 into 2 into 2 into 2. Again in C, 70 equals to 2 into 5 into 7. Then D, 54, 2 into 3 into 9. Can you tell, children, among these 4
which are prime factorized?
So, as I said, prime factorization in the sense they should have only prime numbers. Their product should be only prime numbers. And they have given the product of the factors or product of number as 2, 3, 4. Yes, you all know 2 is a prime, 3 is a prime. Whether 4 is prime? No. Then we cannot take it as a prime factorization. Why? Because 4 is a composite number. Okay, so shall we move to the B? Okay, now you can check 7, 2, 2, 2. Yes, completely. Both 7 and 2 are prime numbers. we can say that statement B is prime factorized. Okay. Next, check with C children. 17. It is equal to 2, 5, 7. Yes, all you can see 2, 5, 7 are the prime numbers and B, C are prime factorized. Next, 54. Okay. 2, 3, 9. So you all know children, 2 prime, 3 is prime. Whereas 9 is prime? No. 9 is composite. So statement A and D are not prime factorized because they have the composite numbers in them. Okay. Okay. Statements B and C are prime factorized. So when you factorize the number, they should have the prime factorized with them. So only statement B and C are prime factorized. So it is all about the question 9. Okay, children. So remaining 3 questions are there. They are of not much important. I am going to tell in my next class. Question number, what is that question number? 7 you have to try. 8 also you have to try. I have given you the hint how to do it. Okay. And remaining 10, 11 and 12 I am going to tell in my other class. Okay, children. Till then, take care. Bye.